Today I'm going to convince you that you're smart. Welcome back, my friends. This is week number 4. I am so excited about this week. This is probably one of my favorite lessons. So let's get into it. So just a reminder, last week we finished how we feel physically. And I know that there was a lot to unpack there. But one of the most important things to take away from that lesson is making sure that you're making healthy choices when it comes to what you're choosing to eat, what you're choosing to watch or listen to, and ultimately who you're choosing to hang out with. Make sure that you're doing your best not to fall under negative influence and set healthy boundaries for yourself. I even talked about your brain and how it develops and some of the things that are out there that can definitely interfere with that development. So today, I think it's only fitting that we talk about how we feel intellectually. Okay, so I wanted to start by asking you this question. Why do we learn? What purpose does it serve? Okay, so while you're pondering that question, let me actually break it down into 3 simple parts. All right, so the capacity to learn is a gift. The ability to learn is a skill, and the willingness to learn is a choice. So what does all of this mean? Well, let me start with the first one. The capacity to learn is a gift. What does that actually mean? Well, you have actually been given a very special gift. You've been given the gift of an education.
You raised my hopes and dashed them quite expertly, sir. Bravo!
Now, look, you might not like the education system, but the foundations of what it's actually built upon that are giving you this opportunity to get your education today is not something to take lightly. You have this amazing opportunity to grow and to broaden your future, and it's just been handed to you. Look, I know that some of you feel like it's been forced upon you, and you're not really wrong.
Let's just eat it. Come on. Here comes the airplane. There you go. Open, open, into the hangar. There you go.
Michael.
Yep, eat it. Put it in your mouth and just eat it.
Take God, a bit. I hate it.
I don't care whether you hate it. You said
Michael,
you'd do it.
All right. Michael.
Eat it. Eat it.
Okay, so even if you feel like this is forced upon you, it would be a real shame if you missed out on the opportunity of what an education system can actually bring to you. There are a lot of people in this world that are far less fortunate than we are. So I hope that you understand what a gift it is that you can actually go to school. All right, now, the ability to learn is a skill. So, what's this all leading up to? What's the point?
What's the point?
All right, so you know what year the Civil War started, and you know how to solve the Pythagorean theorem. So what? I know that a lot of y'all might feel this way. You might have certain classes that you're taking that you're thinking, when am I ever going to use this information in my future? Well, what if I told you that a lot of these things that you're learning today that you might feel are meaningless have so much more meaning behind them?
Intriguing.
So why is this so important? Well, although you might not take that specific information with you once you graduate, what you will take with you are certain abilities. What I'm talking about is the ability to problem solve, to find answers, to do the research, to think critically. You're learning how to work alongside other people, and some of these people you may or may not like, and that's just kind of the truth of the world. One of these days, your boss might ask you to work on a project with a group of people, and you need to have the ability and the skills to work alongside those people, whether you like them or not.
Okay. Hold on, hold on. Judges in session. What is the problem here?
You put my stuff in Jell-O again. That's real professional.
So look, when it comes time for you to graduate and you're up on stage holding your diploma, you're not going to be saying to the world, I know when the Civil War began. No, you're going to be saying, I know how to solve problems. I know how to work alongside other people. I know how to overcome obstacles and deal with pressure. These are the skills that you're going to be taking with you the rest of your life.
To that, I say, all right, all right, all right.
Okay, so now the last one. The willingness to learn is a choice. Now, like I said before, I know that there's a lot of you that probably feel forced to go to school, and you're not wrong. Our government does require you to go to school and get an education, and someone may even be dropping you off at school.
I love you, Miles.
Yeah, I know, Dad. See you Friday.
you gotta say I love you back.
Dad, are you serious?
I wanna hear it.
You wanna hear me
I love
say
you, Dad.
You're dropping me off out of school.
I love you, Dad.
Look at this place.
Dad, I love you.
Dad, I love you.
That's a copy.
Okay, so regardless of if someone is dropping you off at school or if your teachers are forcing you to be in that class,
get over here!
You still have to make the choice if you're going to pay attention, if you're going to actually learn. That's on you. But here's the rub. If you don't value the first two concepts, you're not going to have any desire to learn. But if you understand that what you've been given is a gift, a very valuable gift, something that not everyone in this world has, and this gift is going to give you skills that you can use the rest of your life. If you understand that, it's going to be so much easier for you to focus on your education. Now, I want to share a story so you can understand how fortunate you actually are. This is a story of a girl named Malala. Some of you have probably actually heard of this story before. This is a true story. This is a story of a girl who was faced with certain obstacles and barriers to even get an education. You see, Malala was growing up in the Middle East during this time when the Taliban was prohibiting girls from going to school. In fact, they even threatened to shoot anyone who tried to get an education. However, Malala decided to stand up against the Taliban, and in the process of doing so, she was shot in the head. Now, the amazing part is that she actually survived, and I'm going to share with you a trailer from the documentary that was made about Malala. Y'all take a look.
You named her after a girl who spoke out and was killed. It's almost as if you said she'll be different.
You're right.
Tonight, Malala remains in intensive care.
She was shot in the head for daring to suggest girls should go to school.
I'm still 17. I'm still a teenager.
I don't know how to treat you. This is very bad.
Treated.
Treated?
Mm-hmm. I want people to learn from the experience I had. My father only gave me the name Malala. He didn't make me Malala. There's a moment when you have to choose whether to be silent or to stand up. The Taliban said that no girl can go to school. And if she goes, then you know what we can do.
They shot me on the left side of my forehead. They thought that the bullet would silence us.
Nobody thought that she will survive.
But I am the same Malala. I tell my story not because it is unique. It is the story of many girls.
The Nobel Peace Prize is to be awarded to Malala Yousafzai.
We realize the importance of light when we see darkness. The importance of our voice when we are silenced. Let us pick up our books and our pens. They are our most powerful weapons.
This is an amazing story, and this is unlike any story that we would ever hear in the US. Because no one is telling you that you can't get an education. In fact, it's quite the opposite. They want you to get an education. But did you know that there are so many children around this world that do not have the same opportunities that you have? There are so many of these kids that would love to go to school. They would love to get an education. But maybe they're in a situation like Malala, where they're literally being held at gunpoint saying, you cannot go to school. Maybe they're kids that are literally fighting for their lives, or they themselves have had to become mother and father to all of their siblings because mom and dad are gone. Mom and dad have died. They are the ones that have to take responsibility. They can't get an education. These are the kinds of stories that we don't always hear about. These are the kinds of stories that kids are facing around the world that you're not having to face. You've been given an opportunity to go to school and to broaden your mind and further your education and get that job that you want someday. And look, I know it's hard to take pride in something that's just been handed to you. I understand. But if our education system was something that you had to fight for, that you literally had to die for, wouldn't you take more pride in it? Realize that there are a lot of men and women who have actually died for your right to go to school. Your parents and your families have sacrificed and are sacrificing so that you can get the education that you need. So look, do not take for granted what you've been given. You have this amazing opportunity to broaden your mind and find the future that you want for yourself and to help you and your family. You could be the difference in this generation. You could set a new tone. But it all has to come back to this place of realizing what you've been given. You have a gift. And all the skills that you're learning are things that are going to help you in your future. Don't give up on yourself. I know that it can be a struggle. I've struggled. But I'm here to tell you that you can overcome that and you can make a difference. You just have to believe in yourself.
I can do anything good. Yeah.
All right, so school is a lot like boot camp. All right, when you're going into the Army, the Marines, the Navy, right, you got to go through boot camp. Now, your mission, your goal is to get through boot camp. Your mission, your goal of school is to graduate. But boot camp in and of itself is not always fun, right? You're not necessarily going into boot camp because it's fun. You're going into boot camp so that way you can be prepared for the real world. When you go to war, you know how to take care of yourself. You know how to take care of your buddies, right? But while you're in boot camp, you're going to have a drill sergeant that's yelling at you, that's telling you to crawl through the mud, to do the push-ups, to do the work that you may not want to do, but you got to do it anyway. Well, you got some drill sergeants at school, your teachers. You might really like some of your teachers. You might not like some of your teachers. But they're telling you to do things that you may or may not like, but you need to do them anyway because it's teaching you the valuable skills that you need so you can survive in the real world. You're in boot camp right now. So understand that when you get out there and you have to face these obstacles, you know how to overcome them because you've had to do it while you were in school. All these research papers, all the tests, all the studying, all of that is preparing you for the real world. And if I were you, I wouldn't upset your drill sergeants.
What's your sole purpose in this army?
To do whatever you tell me, drill sergeant.
Okay, so let me introduce you to the Wheel of Intelligence. Now, for some of you, this might not be new information, but I will say that when I was your age, I literally thought there were only two kinds of smart: book smart and common sense. And if you didn't have either of those, you were just plain out of luck. It wasn't until I got into college that I learned just how wrong I was. You see, there's multiple kinds of intelligence. It's not just book smart and common sense. Now, I'm going to go through this wheel of intelligence, and I would love for you to actually write down or just take a mental note of which ones stand out to you. Okay, so the first one that we're going to talk about is body smart. So these are people that understand the body, like nurses, doctors, nutritionists, athletes, physical therapists. It's so important that we have people that understand how the body works and how to help the body become more healthy mentally and physically.
And release all of those sounds that are trapped in your mind.
Sir, are you okay?
I'm a little messed up.
Okay, so the next one is people smart. These are going to be your therapists, your counselors, the inspirational speakers. We could even throw politicians and salesmen and women in there. These people have an amazing ability to understand people's emotions. They know how to speak to people, and a lot of them can be very persuasive.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?
Okay, so next is word smart. This is the book smart, but it's so much more than that. These aren't just people that can read and write. These are storytellers. They're deep thinkers. These are people that understand language and they can pick up on different languages. And some of them even can create their own language. Words can carry so much weight and meaning to them. Think about poetry. So you might not actually think that poetry is very cool, but what about rap music? Do you like it? Well, if you broke down rap, it's basically just poetry in musical form. Especially when it comes to slam poems, a lot of those sound like rap music. Without the gifts and talents and the imagination of the writers of this world, where would we be?
No matter what anybody tells you, words and ideas can change the world. Now see that look in Mr. Pitt's eye, like 19th century literature has nothing to do with going to business school or medical school, right? Maybe. Mr. Hopkins, you may agree with him thinking, yes, we should simply study our Mr. Pritchard and learn our rhyme and meter and go quietly about the business of achieving other ambitions. I have a little secret for you. Huddle up. Huddle up! We don't read and write poetry because it's cute. We read and write poetry because we are members of the human race. And the human race is filled with passion. And medicine, law, business, engineering, these are noble pursuits and necessary to sustain life. But poetry, beauty, romance, love, these are what we stay alive for. To quote from Whitman, "O me, O life of the questions of these recurring, of the endless trains of the faithless, of cities filled with the foolish, what good amid these, O me, O life?" Answer, that you are here, that life exists and identity, that the powerful play goes on and you may contribute a verse. The powerful play goes on, and you may contribute a verse. What will your verse be?
All right, next is logic.
Come hit the consume all of my memories from past and present like two identities. Logic falling off is an obscenity. Top five, I better be steadily listen.
No. I'm not talking about that logic. I'm talking about logic smart. Okay, that was pretty cheesy. Okay, so here we have our mathematicians, our analysts, our accountants, our computer programmers, and engineers. These are the types of people that have a talent for thinking critically and problem solving.
What's 9 plus 10?
21.
Next up, we got nature smart.
We'll be eating in no less than a week.
It's a little soft-shell turtle. Oh, in Indonesia, they cook these things right and these little shells turn into potato chips.
I got him.
Nature Smart may seem very straightforward, but this isn't just your average camper. These people have a keen sense for survival. Think Bear Grylls. Like, there's a lot of men and women in the army that have to go through certain training to learn how to survive in the wilderness. And to be honest, if you dropped me in the middle of the woods, I would try and find the closest Wendy's. I'm not gonna spend the night in the woods. But yeah, there are a lot of skills that are required to survive in the wilderness. You need to know how to hunt, you need to know how to fish, you need to know how to start a fire. But these aren't the only types of people that fall under this category. I would say that there's another big group out there that you might not be thinking about. Farmers. So farmers are very nature smart. They understand the seasons and they know how to grow crops in those seasons. And a lot of them are having to learn how to yield crops in new climates. We need good farmers out there to produce the crops that are going to keep us alive, especially as we move into our future. All right, so next we got self smart. Now this is pretty similar to people smart, but the one big difference is that self smart people understand how they feel and they're able to communicate that really well.
Me? I know who I am. I'm a dude playing a dude disguised as another dude.
What?
They understand how their actions influence the people around them. Not a lot of people have this skill. A lot of people are lacking in this area and they don't fully understand how to communicate their feelings that well. But much like therapists and counselors, it's important that we have these types of people that can help us communicate how we feel and especially work through some of our emotions. Next on the list, we got my personal favorite, picture smart, no bias. So these are your visual learners. The I'd rather watch the movie than read the book, if you know what I'm saying.
How can you read this? There's no pictures.
Picture smart people tend to fall into the more creative category. These are going to be your actors, your filmmakers, your designers, your architects. You may tend to find that you actually do better in class if you can draw or doodle. I know that for me, my notes always look like this. Versus this. All right, so finally we got music smart. Now this is another one that may seem very straightforward, right? These are going to be your musicians, your singers, your songwriters, but But these are people that have this amazing ability to connect people through music. This is such a cool gift because this is honestly a universal language. Everybody loves music. Now, not everybody loves the same type of music, but there's something special about music that everybody can connect to.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who? And I said, who let those doggone dogs out? I said, who let the special the pit bull? Who let those dogs out?
Okay, so now that we worked through all of those, let's just say, for example, that you want to become a professional comedian someday. So what off of the Wheel of Intelligence do you think is going to work best for that profession? Well, you're probably going to need a little bit of people smart or self smart, right? You need to understand people and you need to be able to connect to them and understand their emotions. I would also say that you need to have word smart, especially if you're going to write your own material. You need to be good with those words and make sure that it's translating very clearly when you're up on stage. Also, you need to be picture smart. You need to have that creative side. So when you are on stage, you can bring your imagination to life and it can really excite the people that you're entertaining. I hope that you found a few of these things really insightful. And like my good friend Matthew McConaughey says,
knowing who we are is hard. It's hard. So give yourself a break. Eliminate who you are not first, and you're gonna find yourself where you need to be.
Okay, so I don't actually know Matthew McConaughey personally. I wish I did. Matthew, if you're watching this, reach out to me. But what he says here is really good. You got to eliminate who you're not first. If you do that, it's going to be so much easier to figure out who you are. So out of this wheel of intelligence, eliminate the ones that you're not. And that's going to set you in the direction that you need to go so that way you know who you are and what you want to do. Okay, so the last thing before we end, I want to share my story really quick. Now, my whole life I've struggled with dyslexia and ADD. I struggled in school a lot. I hated reading. Still to this day, it's not my favorite. I'd rather watch the movie than read the book. But I knew that I would have to overcome these obstacles in order to succeed in life. But school was just not my thing. I wasn't very good at it. I was never a straight A student. I struggled to even get B's in class. It wasn't that I wasn't trying. I really was. I just was so far behind everyone else. Or at least I felt that way. I remember there were multiple days that I would just come home and cry. I was really depressed and I just had this mindset of I'm not good enough, I'm not smart enough, I'll never make it. Now, when it came to my junior senior year of high school, I started taking the ACT and the SAT. For those of you that don't know, these are tests that you have to pass in order to even be accepted into college. So I started taking these tests and I wasn't doing very good. I kept failing. And the hardest part was seeing a lot of my friends that were passing, even on their first try. Here I was on my fifth, sixth, seventh try, still failing. Well, lucky for me, I had some teachers in my life that could see my potential, that knew that if I was given enough time, I can actually achieve the same things that normal people can do. So I had a teacher that actually reached out to the company that does the ACT and the SAT test and proved to them that I have dyslexia. They actually said that I would be able to take the test with extra time. So that's what I did. I remember going into the classroom with this teacher, sitting down, taking this test, and having extra time. Now, I still didn't finish the whole test on time. There was so much reading that was required that it was just going over my head. But I felt confident. I felt like this time I actually made a difference. And it turns out that I did pass, barely. But this was a huge moment in my life. I felt so proud of myself that I'd finally accomplished this big goal. Now, I was accepted into ACU, and I started my first year on probation. Basically, what that means is that if I failed any of my classes that first semester, they would kick me out, and I wouldn't be able to come back. So I had to work really hard to prove that I am smart, that I'm capable of doing the work. Did I struggle in college? Yeah. But for those of you that have seen my first video, you know that I graduated from ACU. And that's a pretty big accomplishment for me. Because I know how hard it was for me to get an education, to actually stay focused and to do the work and do the research. And in the back of my mind, I always had those thoughts of, am I good enough? Am I going to be able to do this? but I proved to myself and to the world that I could do it. And so the same thing goes for you. You might be struggling like I struggled. Maybe you're not. Maybe you don't struggle in the same way, but there's probably something that you are struggling with. And sometimes the voices in our head can convince us that we're not good enough, that we shouldn't even try or we should give up. But I want to encourage you. Understand that, yes, there's a lot of pressure out there. And there's a lot of people that can say that you're not good enough or you should give up. But if you believe in yourself and you keep pushing through, I promise that you can overcome any obstacle that's set in your way. Really quickly, I just want to give a huge shout out to my teachers. And for all the teachers that are watching this right now, you guys are the superheroes. I just am in awe of what you do every single day. I am so thankful that we have people like you in the world. For the students that are watching this, I would encourage you to give a word of encouragement to your teachers today. Make sure that you show appreciation to your teachers because they're putting in a lot of work and effort to be there for you every single day. And that's not always the easiest thing to do, especially when you have students that were like me. You had to have a lot of patience, and I appreciate the patience that you have for students that may be a little bit behind, that may be struggling, that need that extra push in life. Without teachers like you in this world, I may not be here today giving this speech. I might not have had the opportunities to actually do what I enjoy if it weren't for teachers like you. So from the bottom of my heart, I just want to say thank you.
I wanted to thank you for helping me.
All right, so let's bring it all back to the positive action wheel. I want to talk about my story really quick because realistically, it started with a negative action wheel. My thoughts were, I'm not smart enough. I'm not good enough. I can't do this. And a lot of my actions were negative. I was going about not feeling good about myself. Sometimes I would get angry or lash out. And at the end of the day, I just didn't feel very good. But once I started transitioning into this place of understanding that I might not be word smart, I might not have that book smart, but I am visually smart. I am good with people. I understand who I am. And so all of a sudden my thoughts were more positive. I am smart. I am talented. And that started creating positive actions. I was going around feeling more encouraged and it was helping me encourage other people. And then I was feeling better. So that's the thing to take with you is to understand that you might be struggling in certain areas. You might not like all your classes. What are your thoughts? When you step into that class, are you instantly saying, I'm not going to enjoy this class. I don't like this class. I'm not good at it. So I'm not going to put forth effort. Well, those actions are not going to be very positive. And you're probably not going to feel very good because your grade is going to reflect those actions, which might not be a very good grade. But if you go in thinking, you know what, this is an opportunity to learn and to grow. I might not like this teacher. I might not like this class, but I'm going to do everything in my power to give it my all. And I guarantee if you do that, you're going to have much better results. So it's always important to bring it back here. What is your thought and how is that going to influence your future? All right. So I really appreciate you guys. I hope that the stories that I shared today, and I honestly just hope that the information that I gave you is something that you can take with you the rest of your life. You are smart. You can overcome any obstacle that you set your mind to. Don't give up on yourself. Don't give up on other people. You can make it. So as always, links are going to be in the description down below. I hope that you have a great day. Y'all take care.